Hello to my beautiful LGBTQIA people, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Kier Michael. Today I want to do kind of like a follow-up video to the last video that I post, where I talked about why H&M thinks that the gay community are sex addicts. If you haven't seen that video, I highly suggest that you watch that before you watch this one. The way that H&M represented the gay community just was not ideal. Our moment in between is a makeout session in the back alley. That is not our community in a nutshell. We kind of do this to ourselves. You see how I had to like sit up because it's about to get serious? We kind of did this to ourselves. We do love and we overindulge in sex. Not everybody, of course. This is not a generalization. H&M put us in that back alley is because they know that that's what we do. They know that that is gay life as a 20-something year old. Why are we so addicted to sex? Maybe this is just from my perspective. Comment down in the comments below and talk to me. I want to know because from my experience, this is what I see. And then I see us in this H&M commercial, I'm like, what the f? And then I'm like, actually, it makes sense. One thing that I noticed that I think makes us more prone to overindulging in sex is these dating apps. And I'm just gonna throw out the most popular one, which is Grindr, of course. I feel like it's kind of like a Grindr trap. Stick with me with this. Here you are, a young kid, and you just came out. So let's say, for me, it was around like 18 when all this happened. For some people, it's younger. So you're 18, you're fresh to the scene, you just came out, you're excited, and you're like, I wanna like meet other gay people, I wanna celebrate my gayness, I finally accepted myself, I wanna be out to everybody and just wave my fucking rainbow flag in the parade, and I just wanna be like Noah, and I was ready to find my way, and I was ready to find my friends, and be best friends with them, and like do little gay stuff with them, and like live your best gay life. As I was just getting out and coming out to the scene, I noticed I didn't feel embraced by my community. I couldn't really find my community. It was kind of like just pride, and pride, like I said, is just kind of like a big whole bunch of shirtless men, their boobs all out, and it's like, okay, like I like that there's gay people here, I'm excited that there's gay people here, but it's all just like very overly sexualized, and you're just like, eh, whatever, I'm just happy to be around gay people, so you just kind of go with the flow. And I went with the flow, and then I was like, I really want to meet somebody, I want to date. And then you download the dating apps, and this is where the trap comes in. You get on the dating apps, and all these men, the majority of them are a little bit older, a little bit more seasoned in how to get what they want, and you're on there, this fresh, cute little tight butt face. Well, your butt, your face isn't tight, but your butt is tight, and your face is flawless and smooth, and you know, you got your little profile picture, and you're trying to like, you know, get your angles right, and like, you're cute, you're out, and you're just like, I'm about to meet me a man, I'm about to have a boyfriend, I'm Noah, looking for my weight, and I'm about to be living my best gay life. No. That is not what happens. You get on those apps, and these guys will say and do anything that they need to do to get your butt, specifically get your butt in their bed. And that's where the trap happens, is you're fresh to the scene, you're new to the scene, and you're so vulnerable and so open, and then someone swoops in and catches you, and you kind of like think, oh, I don't want to do that, I don't want to da 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 da, and you like disregard them, and then it happens again, and then it happens again, and we all know at this point, this day and age, these gay dating apps are gay hookup apps. Like, they're just hookup sites. They're not for dating. And these kids are getting on there. Like me, when I was 18, I got on there and I got caught up. And that's all it was. It was like, if I couldn't offer anything sexually, I wasn't a part of the community. I couldn't have any gay people in my life. And then it was like, okay, I'm gonna try to find friends outside of the apps. And it happened in person as well. Majority of my friends, it's always some little tension chemistry where it's almost like they want something more. And that has happened countless times to me where a gay friend, it might not be evident at first, but down the line you realize all they wanted to do was sleep with you. And maybe they are a good friend, maybe they are a great person, but they still want that friends with benefits like type thing. And it just makes me wonder, why? Why are we so overly sexualized? Why are we so sex driven? Yeah, we're men and it's two men and all that great stuff, but why can't we have that self-discipline? And I think Grindr and these other gay dating apps are a big component to that, is because we are kind of conditioned when we're younger that this is what it is, and we fall into that trap. I mean, think about how you were when you were younger. You weren't really sure what gay was and what it was like to be gay and around other gay people, and they show you, oh, this is what you do, this is what you do. You kind of just fall into that trap because you want to be loved and accepted because you didn't have that. Especially me, my family, I had to be something else to get that love and acceptance, and I love them to death, but I couldn't be my true, full, authentic self without feeling some type of uncomfortable. And when I came out and I found these gay people, whether it be in person or through these apps, I finally felt comfortable. But I kind of fell into this trap where it was like I had to keep going with the flow, otherwise I wouldn't have these friends. And I was like, oh, so it's either I go back and pretend with my family and just act like this to be loved and accepted, or I act gay, which is truly who I am, and I can't stop that, but I still have to act a certain way so I can be loved and accepted by them. And that's where the trap happens, is you choose gay because you've already established that you can't change your sexuality, and you've honed that in, and you're out to yourself, and you're great, and you're out to everybody. But now it's like you have to play the part to keep these gay friends, to stay a part of your community, because you don't want to be shunned again. That is not a great feeling. So yeah, I think it's kind of a trap. What do you guys think? Do you think that these gay dating apps contributes to why we overindulge in sex, and why everything is about sex and everything turns into sex? Let me know in the comments below, because I'm curious to know, why are gay men so overly sexualized? If you like what you see, you like my conversation, you like my different perspective, you like my personality, you like my energy, click the subscribe button below. To all my LGBTQIA people and my affirming allies, we love you guys so much. Thank you for your support. Live your best gay life.